Stand by to repel boredom because it's general ignorance time. Alan, yeah? I believe you've got something inside your desk.
Have I?
Yeah, have you not looked? You sound like a schoolboy there. So, what is that?
It's a loofah.
And where do loofahs come from?
The bathroom.
And originally?
From the, they're in the sea.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. No, you knew that, did you, Sean?
Yeah.
Where are they from?
You grow them, they're little seeds.
That's right. They're, yeah. they're
I got the worst Christmas present ever. Ever in my life. My sister gave me a grow-your-own loofah kit.
God bless her.
It was a clay pot, a bag of earth and five seeds. Well, I think the clay pot hit her hardest.
Anyway, it is surprising most people, including myself this morning, until I saw this question, I have to say, believed that loofahs came from the sea. Did you think loofahs came from the sea?
I would have said, not my vegetable garden.
Yeah. Well, they grow in Asia and Africa, and they are quite prized. They can be sliced and diced and popped into curries and soups and things like that. And
no way.
And they've been rubbing a nana's back, though.
Stone Eastern is a classic country house hotel deep in the Somerset countryside with a quirky little secret. Visitors enjoy the familiar rhythm of afternoon tea and dinner at 8, but once a year, a strange ritual takes place in this quiet country hotel. The annual loofah harvest is a unique day that draws curious guests from all around the country to take part in what quickly has become a tradition at the house. They are carefully germinated and grown by head gardener Dorian Poole, who knows exactly the right time in autumn to pick the loofahs.
I think loofah day just attracts people for its sheer novelty value, and people don't really know anything about loofahs. I think most people assume when we ask them that loofahs grow under the sea, where actually they grow in glass houses and have been doing so for hundreds of years in this country. So it's just a nice traditional thing and it's slightly quirky.
The harvest is a big draw for curious guests who are keen to know more about this bizarre fruit.
People enjoy learning about them and we use them in the guest bedroom, so when people come and stay here, there's every chance they'll have a loofah in their room as a gift that they can use that we've grown.
But it's not just these natural exfoliants that are grown here. Stone Eastern has an extensive kitchen garden, providing flowers for display and produce for the busy kitchen. At the beginning of the growing season, Dorian Poole consults with head chef Matthew Butcher about what he wants to serve throughout the seasons. He also tries to introduce some new seedlings or heirloom vegetables that will end up in delectable dishes on the dining table.
The kitchen garden here has a really fascinating history. It was installed in 1830 and it was put in by a lady called Elizabeth Ann Horner, who was the great-great-great-granddaughter of Little Jack Horner of nursery rhyme fame. And she came here as the mistress of the house following the death of Richard Hipsley Cox's first wife. He was a famous spendthrift who had nearly bankrupted the family, and she came with a large dowry of money and also great housekeeping skills, and she saved the family from bankruptcy. But she was famous as a local apothecary, so she was known far and wide as somebody who would heal the poor, basically. And she created this garden in order to grow vegetables and herbs that she would make tinctures and lotions and potions from that she would then dispense to the villagers as a way of trying to heal them. So that's why the garden was created.
So, let's get down to it. How do you prepare a loofah? First, you must check the fruit to see that it has lost weight. This means that it has dried out and is ready to be peeled. Tap the loofah to crack the skin and to reveal the fibre inside. Then, it's on to the messy bit. You will need to remove all of the flesh and seeds from inside of the fruit, so it is best to run it under a tap while firmly squeezing the flesh out of the end or banging it against the side of the sink. Once the loofah is free of all seeds and juice, just hang it to dry in a well-ventilated area for a couple of days. Then they're ready for the bath.
People just seem to be fascinated. People come back more than once, and so people book, almost a year in advance. So we do about 100 people each year go through the loofah harvest.